Yeah, the cushion.
Yeah, that's right.
You'll be fine. What are you gonna do for exercise? Lower body.
Yeah,
I use compensation here.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's good.
Yes, you can walk.
Yeah, you can, yeah.
You can walk.
Keep your
Yeah.
lower body up. You won't be walking in the gym.
No.
Not that at all. 3 months. After a while, you're gonna want to.
Oh,
Oh, absolutely. Yeah,
that's
hip
a good one.
box. Yeah.
Hips,
Yep.
ACL.
Yeah. Materials. Yeah.
Sweatpants. Eight surgery, 10 years.
You do. It's all the yoga.
It's all the work.
It's all the
Yeah.
yoga.
It's the yoga. It's Nancy.
How are you feeling today? You guys enjoying your day? So beautiful out.
So nice.
Yeah. Really is. Love this time of year. Could it
Yes.
just stay
Yeah.
like November all year long?
It reminds you why you live here.
Well, sure, yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, so we gotta endure the 6 months of sweating. And then it just, oh, like meditation. Oh. We have one more minute. Let's see if usually Claudia jumps on. Everybody sign in? So next week, normal week, but then Thanksgiving week, I'll just be here on Monday. And then I'll be gone the rest of the
Cooking or
week.
traveling?
No. I'm like, oh, do I even divulge what I'm
Okay.
doing now? So
It has to do with the bike.
it does. It has to do with a bike.
Even Thanksgiving
Oh.
weekend, they have.
Thanksgiving Day. Can you believe it? So it's called the Race of Champions. So catch you up, Leo. My son is a BMX racer. There's a BMX track right over here, not far from here at Golden Gate. And we stumbled upon it 4 years ago. And he's been racing ever since. He's turning 12 next month. So every state has their own state series. And Florida's is big, like really big. Like we get like over 1,000 riders at our state series races. So Aiden finished in the top 10
Nice,
last
congrats to
this
him.
year. It's still this year in May. And every state series, then the kids that finish in the top 10 get invited to Race of Champions. 2 years ago, he got it as well. Last year, he didn't make it, and he's one win away from turning expert. So, if that happens, I just don't know what the chances of him ever making top 10 again are. Because those kids are like doing the national series, they're homeschooled, they're on the track every day. Like, that's not us.
It's commitment.
Barrett, yes. So I was like, there's three other kids from our track that made it. So me and the dads. My husband manages the hotel and it's full Thanksgiving week, so there's just no way for him to get away. So yep, guess where it is?
Oh, where? Orlando, right? Florida.
That would make sense, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oklahoma.
Has
Tulsa.
anyone ever been
Interesting.
to Tulsa, Oklahoma? Can you fill me in?
I saw the Tulsa, Tulsa Kick series.
No.
It looks pretty, flat and steady.
I loved the
Serious.
Broadway show Oklahoma. Oklahoma, where the witch comes. Anyway,
Interesting.
so yeah, so
Yeah,
that
that's
Monday night, so there's a direct flight out of Tampa into Tulsa. So going up to Tampa Monday night, flying to Tulsa Tuesday morning. He races on Thanksgiving Day, so fingers crossed he they take the top four from those rounds, and then they go to ace the next day. Ace, quarters, semis, mains. You get it down to the final eight rounds. So luckily that there's two dads that are driving. So all the bikes are going with them.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. And even bags, like we're doing just on our backs and go. Yeah. So that works out okay. So yeah, it'll be an adventure.
Always is.
I know, right?
Yeah.
I will always have it to talk about.
Yeah. On Thanksgiving.
Yeah. I know. I'm gonna get the history on that.
Yeah.
When I'm there. I hope they had to send out a different link. I hope Claudia saw that. All right, well, let's get started. So finding a seat. So if you grab a block and place it under, see how Rose is doing it? How she's got it under her sits bones? Yeah. And see if that's any more comfortable for you. All right, sit up nice and tall. Take a deep breath in through the nose. Let's sigh it out through the mouth. Actually gonna shake things up. Let's go on to our backs. I know, right?
I am just feeling it. So a little mini shavasana to start, middle of the day, right? They do this over in Europe. A little siesta, no, don't go to sleep. But just allow just the activity from the day so far to settle. Bring your hands to your belly. Spread your fingers and just tune into your breath, your natural breath. Don't manipulate it in any way. Just feel the rise and fall. Start to calm the whirlings of the mind. So anything that was going on before you came into the room, anything that you have going on afterwards, just let it start to settle as your back begins to settle, as you allow the support of the earth beneath us to rise up to hold you. It's not an easy task. Our brain wants to continue thinking, and it's not really asking you to stop all thoughts. It's more just an awareness of the thoughts coming and going, and see if you can maybe interject a pause in between the thoughts to just slow them down a little bit, and maybe practice, if a thought comes into the mind, practice coming back to focusing only on your breath. Focus on maybe a part of the body that may need a little extra attention. Maybe we can all send healing thoughts to Steve's shoulder. Inviting in loving kindness, compassion into each breath. Exhaling any negative self-talk, any negative thoughts. Allow yourself to be here right now. Let the arms release from the belly down to your sides, a little bit of away from the side of your body, and flip your palms up, allowing the heart space and chest to open a little bit as the shoulders rotate back. Just notice any shifts with how your back is needing support. Notice if you're still grasping or clenching anywhere in the body, maybe in the legs, in the feet. Check in with the belly, softening it. Check
Check in with the arms, the hands, the fingers. Check in with your shoulders. Notice if you're trying to hold them up, see if you can allow them to drop just a little bit more. Thinking about our meditation practice today, thinking of it in terms of replacing visuals of busyness. So, what comes to your mind when you think of busy? Maybe driving in a car, other cars around, maybe standing in a line, waiting for something. With each thought that comes into your mind of busyness, replace it with something calm, serene. And that's going to be different for everyone, but maybe some suggestions are looking out to the water. Maybe watching a sunset or sunrise. Maybe there's a place in your home where you feel calm. So swapping out a new visual of busyness with a visual of calm. And taking a body scan again, noticing if those visuals help shift anything for you. Notice if any parts of the body softened a little bit more. We're slowly going to add a little bit of movement here, so just keep the eyes soft or closed, and on your next inhale, float your arms overhead, and exhale them down alongside the body. Inhale the arms overhead, and exhale them down alongside. This time, sweep them up along the floor like you're making angel wings. So inhale them up to a wide V and exhale, lower them down. Just notice here the difference in the shoulder rotation. Inhale, lifting them up to a wide V and exhale them back down. One more time, inhale, bringing them up toward that wide V, and exhale, lowering them down, and then start sliding your heels toward your sit bones, drawing the knees in toward your chest. Leave your head on the mat and just rock from side to side. Straighten the legs up toward the ceiling for a couple of breaths. They don't have to straighten all the way, just finding some extension here in the legs. And then exhale, re-bend the knees. Two more times. Inhale, reaching them, the feet up to the sky. And exhale, re-bend. Inhale, one more time up to the sky. And re-bend, and then take the knees out wide, bring the soles of the feet together, reach your fingers around your shins to see if you can start drawing the heels towards.
towards you, towards your pubic bone. Just here in our Supta Baddha Konasana, our butterfly pose on our back, just breathing into this gentle opening for the hips. Three more breaths, inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale, and then bring the knees back together. Rolling onto your right side and extend your arms so you've got it under your head. Take a couple breaths here before we come up to a seat. Maybe even sigh the breath out. Slowly making your way up, pressing into that left hand, kind of circling yourself up to a seat, crossing the legs, and just bringing the chin parallel with the floor. And soften the gaze again, bring your hands to your heart center, and set an intention for your practice today. So wherever you are in this meditation practice, just honoring it and knowing that it does take practice. So being just here and in the now, accepting where you are is where you're supposed to be. And let's open with the sound of Om. So inhale the breath, sigh it out through the mouth. Flickering the eyes open, let's rock forward to tabletop and just warm up a little bit, stretching the body. So finding tabletop with the knees under the hips. Move your hands forward just a little bit so the wrists are coming just in front of your shoulders. Draw the belly in. On your inhale, lifting the crown of the head, tilting your tailbone up into cow pose, and then reverse it, exhaling into cat. And continue to move like that at your own pace and see if you can inhale and then let the movement follow. And then start your exhale, and then let the movement follow the exhale. Couple more rounds. And then after cat pose, come to neutral. And we'll make a C shape with our body. So sort of push the hips over the left as you look over your right shoulder. Inhale through center, make that C shape over to the right. And move like that a few times with your breath. Just noticing how the side feels, each side. And it's more like shifting the hip, so getting into that C shape, then rocking from side to side. And then come back to neutral. Take the knees as wide as your mat, bring your toes to touch. Allow yourself to let the chest melt toward the earth. Forehead. If that's too low, slide a block under. Let the elbows just bow out to the sides a little bit so the arms soften and you're able to surrender here into child's pose. A pose that really helps us feel the breath, feel the fullness of the breath, feel the expansion of the rib cage.
Moving up, down, side to side, front to back. Also feeling the breath maybe wrap around the low back, traveling to the low back to help release any tension. We get into the hips here, but it's really a pose to help us release tension from the low back. So bringing all your awareness to the low back for this next breath in and out. Inhale to rise, bringing the knees back under the hips. Draw the belly in as we step both feet back, finding plank pose, and then use your exhale to lift you up into downward facing dog, keeping your heels lifted high. Keep your heels off the mat, lift them really high. Feel that extension in the arms and in the spine, and then look between your hands and rock the body back down to plank pose. Exhale, hips lift you into downward dog, keeping the heels lifted. One more time, rock the body forward and down into plank, and then back into downward facing dog. Lift your gaze, look between your hands and heel toe and feet up to the front of the mat. Lift up halfway. To find a flat back where you feel like you're lengthening from your tailbone out through the crown of the head. The belly's engaged here, nice. The shoulders are lifted a little bit. Gaze looking down. Drawing the navel toward the spine, bend the knees, soften the knees, and then drop the head down, drop chin to chest, and roll up the rest of the way to stand. Inhale the arms overhead, interlace the fingers, index fingers pointing straight up for Kali Mudra. Draw the belly in, inhale to lengthen, and exhale, side bend to the left. Inhale through center, side bend over to the right. Inhale through center, see if your index fingers can lead you to lengthen. Inhale through center, side bend over to the right. One more time, each side. Inhale through center, over to the left. And we take it over to the right. Center. Keep the fingers interlaced and bring them behind the head, cradling the head. Draw the elbows back a little bit outside of the peripheral vision. Continue to root down through the feet for stability as we inhale to lengthen and then arch the upper back a little bit. Stay here for a breath. Exhale, maybe a little bit deeper, drawing the elbows back. One more breath, inhale, really lengthening up through the spine, and exhale, arching a little deeper, and then come back forward, drawing the elbows toward each other. And we'll take six breaths to get down. So inhale, and then exhale, drop chin to chest. Inhale, exhale, lower a little bit more. So very slow spinal roll down to our forward fold. Being aware of each vertebrae as we lower. Probably feeling it a little bit now in your hamstrings. You can bend your knees at any time to soften. Maybe the gaze looking at the knees right now. One more breath in,
And on your exhale, bend the knees a lot. Belly resting on the thighs. And then take your elbows out wide again, lifting the belly off of the thighs. Next inhale, straighten the legs, bringing you up to stand. That arching of the upper back. And then exhale to Dasana. So just a beautiful way to wake up the spine, moving it in opposite directions. And then inhale the arms overhead. And exhale, lowering into our forward fold. Grab your blocks. Place them on either side of your knees, bending the knees and stepping the right leg back, dropping that right knee down to come into Anjaneyasana. So putting the arms up by the ears at the shoulders. Do you feel tight? Separate the arms a little bit wider. Wide feet. Just finding some balance here. Visualize your hips drawing toward your midline. One more breath here. Exhale the hands down to your blocks and bring them underneath your shoulders at the highest heights, and then flip your left toes up. So finding our half split stretch, half Hanumanasana. Lead with your heart as you hinge forward toward that left leg. The right hip staying in line with right knee so that we're not sitting back, but keeping that in line with each other. Left foot stays flexed. Breathe in. Breathe out. Inhale to rise. Rock forward on that left foot and bring your blocks forward. Tuck your right toes under and lift that knee up. So we're in low lunge. We're going to add a twist here. Keep your right hand on the block. Inhale, left arm up, finding a twist. Press into that left foot. Lengthen, really extend that right leg. Full breath in, and then exhale. Drop that left hand down, push off your right foot and step it forward. Inhale, find that flat back, half lift. Exhale, bend the knees, plant the hands and step the left leg back. Dropping that left knee down. Uncurl the toes and we float up to Anjaneyasana. So believe it or not, you might not feel like a whole lot's going on here, but Anjaneyasana really isolates your psoas muscle. And it's nice to think about working at about 30% here to help the psoas muscle not be in a contracted state. One more breath in, and then exhale, hands to the blocks, setting up for that half split pose. So blocks under the shoulders. Flip the right heel to the mat, keeping the right foot flexed. And this might be a deep stretch for you right here, but if you want to deepen a little bit at a time, bring that chest toward the right leg. And now our left hip in line with left knee. Sometimes if we're over-efforting in a pose, we're working against ourselves, sometimes inviting in a mantra, like let go, inhaling the word let, and exhale go, sometimes helps us to soften and release into a pose. Inhale to lift back up, rocking onto the right foot, bring your blocks to frame that right foot, tuck your left toes under to lift up. Left hand stays on the block as we lift the right arm up. You can deepen the bend in that right knee a little bit.
to come to 90 degrees. Notice right knee, right ankle are in line. You can really press into the ball of that left foot to strengthen and lengthen that left leg. Reach up through the right finger so you're not dumping weight in the left shoulder. One more full breath in, and then exhale that right hand down. And then press off the left foot to bring it forward. Inhale to a half lift. And then exhale, drop into your forward fold and hold opposite elbows so that you're hanging like a raggedy Ann doll. And just let the head be heavy here. Maybe add a little swaying from side to side. Breathe in, sigh it out through the mouth if that feels good, or just an exhale through the nose. And then come up to a half lift, bring your hands to your hips, and this time lift with a flat back. And Tadasana, reset breath, inhale. And exhale, let's bring the right, move your block a little bit. Bring your right foot behind your left so the edges of your feet come together. And we're gonna fold here, hands to hips. We meet with the heart as we hinge forward. Maybe grabbing a block at any point to rest the fingertips on. And let this evolve with your breath, let this unfold. Noticing that it takes a little bit more of our balance, keep holding, a little bit more of our balance to stay rooted here. Notice what muscles are activated. One more breath in, and then exhale as you bend your left knee, deepening the stretch in the right leg just a little bit more. One more breath in and out from hands to hips, pressing into the feet to lift yourself up to stand and release that foot. Find Tadasana, reset breath. Inhale. Maybe rock forward and back from the balls of the feet to the heels. And then we'll do that on the other side. So taking left foot behind the right, hands to hips, setting up for the hinging forward. Use your block as you need to. Noticing how the weight of the body shifts a little bit. Yeah, you could practice balance here if you want. Maybe put the arms out to the sides or to heart center. Another breath in and out, and then start to bend that right knee a little bit. Feeling a little deeper stretch in the left leg. If you have a death grip on your toes, see if you can soften those. And then we lift, bring hands to hips, press into the feet, lift yourself up to stand and release that foot. And it's time to shake it out. All kinds of muscles working there, IT band, hip flexors, hamstrings. All right, let's come to a seat. And keeping our feet on the mat and our knees in front of us, we're gonna do a series of twists here. So starting with our TP twist, sitting up on your sits bones, wrap your left arm in front of the knees and take your right hand behind. You can use a block here.
if that helps to find a taller spine or tenting the fingertips. Three more breaths. One more full inhale and exhale. And then inhale, coming through center, wrap the right arm in front of the knees, taking the left hand behind. So with five breaths, gives us the opportunity to move into the twist with each exhale versus moving into the deepest part of your twist right from the start. So just use your inhale and exhale to move you deeper into the twist. One more breath in and out. Come through center and extend your legs out in front of you. Sitting up on your sits bones, maybe move the flesh away and flexing the feet, draw your right knee into the chest and step it over the left leg. So setting up for Ardha Matsyendrasana, right hand coming behind. Inhale, left arm up by the ear and twist to the right. So stay here, or if you want to take it a little deeper, rock onto your left hip, bend the left knee, bringing that left heel closer in by your sits bone, and coming back into the twist. So the full expression of this pose. So we were like this. So you rock onto that left hip, bend the left knee. So this helps. So that heel is coming close by the sit bone, but your right foot is still able to ground. And then coming into the twist. Or just keep that leg straight. So Leo, just go ahead and keep the leg straight for now. And yeah, if your sits bones can't root down comfortably with bending the knee, then keep the leg straight. And it's just something to work for. For those who bent the leg, go ahead and rock to straighten the left leg, and then we'll all release. Shake out the legs, windshield wiper the feet. Took me about 5 years to be able to do that, just so you know. Flexing the feet, draw left knee into the chest, step it over the right. So we'll all start here. Flip that right arm up to the ear and then twist left. Pressing the toe ball mound of your left foot into the mat. Couple more breaths. And if you want to rock onto the right hip a little bit, bend that right knee to bring the heel toward that sits bone. Letting that sits bone drop back down, coming back into the twist. Otherwise, keep that leg extended and just continue to breathe into the twist. Both ways help release our hip flexors, massage our intestines. If you bent that knee, go ahead and straighten it back out.
and then we'll all release that left foot, shake it up. Coming onto our back, shift your sits bones towards your heels, and then come down onto your back. And drop your feet to the mat. Draw your right knee into your chest and turn it out so your right ankle rests on the left thigh, making a figure four. And then with your right hand, gently press the inside of that right knee away from you. On your next inhale, let that right knee come toward your left shoulder. And on your exhale, gently press it away. Inhale, draw it near towards your left shoulder. It's not going to reach it, just in that direction. And then exhale, the hand to the inside of the knee. Two more times. And then keeping it in this figure four, lower your hand down to where your top of your thigh meets your hip and press the base of your palm into that space. Breathe in and exhale, four, three, two, and one. And then we're going to drop this right foot down to the floor, creating a little bit of spinal twist here. Let your left knee rest against the outside of that ankle. And then take your right arm out to the side, palm face up. So revolve. A little bit of a spinal twist here, but also stretching our IT band. Your left hand can stay wrapped around, the left fingers can wrap around your right ankle to help keep it in place. Or if it feels rooted and pressing into the floor, you can take the left arm out from the shoulder. And then settling in here. Breathing in and out. Soften any part of the body that's not needing to work right now. And then slowly rolling back up to center. Release that right foot and heel toe your feet as wide as your mat. Separating the knees and then windshield wiper the knees over to the right. Inhale them through center and drop them down to the left. Inhale through center over to the right. And inhale through center over to the left. And then come back to center, heel toe your feet a little closer. Draw the left knee into the chest. Turn that knee out, resting your left ankle bone on the right thigh, keeping this left foot flexed, and then take the hand to the inside of that left knee, gently pressing it away from you. Hold it here first before we move with this knee. And then on your inhale, draw that left knee toward right shoulder. And exhale, press it away from you. Inhale it toward the right shoulder. And exhale it away from you. Inhale, draw it toward the right shoulder and press it away from you. One more time. Inhale. And exhale, and then we'll take the base of the palm down, pressing it into that space just where your thigh is meeting the hip. Five, four, three, two, and one. And then we'll Let this left foot drop down to the floor, rotating the right thigh and knee down along with it, coming into the spinal twist on the other side. Left arm extends out from the shoulder, palm face up. You can even help that shoulder a little bit. You can press into the back of the head, lift the chest up, and then glide the shoulder blade under. And then soften. Inhale, let. Exhale, go. So silently repeating those words to yourself on your inhale and exhale. Next inhale, begin to rock back to center, to your back, releasing that left foot, heel toe your feet out as wide as your mat again to windshield wiper the knees in between, just to help release all of that. And then heel toe your feet closer together and grab one of your blocks. Press into your feet to lift your hips up and slide the block under your sacrum at the lowest height. We're going to open up the psoas muscle here. So really allow that block to support that bony part of your low back. And then start walking your feet out toward the top of your mat, extending the legs out long. You can keep the arms where they are, or bring the arms to cactus arms, where you're bending the elbows at 90 degrees and the backs of the arms are resting on the floor. Or you might find that the arms reach overhead, so creating length here from fingertips out through the toes and letting the back surrender to the support of the block. So keep holding here.
Notice the sensations happening in the pelvis area as you surrender just a little bit more. Maybe inviting in that mantra here, inhaling the word let, and exhale, go. As we prepare the body for our meditation today, one more breath in. Exhale the arms alongside. Walk the feet back in so you can press into the feet and lift up off the block. Drawing the knees into your chest. Either roll onto your right side to make your way up to a seat, or maybe start to rock forward and back. Coming all the way up, getting enough momentum to bring yourself up. And then choosing your seat today. So I think we've explored all the options. I also brought the chair out. So doing meditation in a chair is also very nice. So either using the block to prop up the hips, or as Rose is demonstrating, hero's pose, coming onto her knees and then using the blocks under her seat. So choosing the seat that you're going to be most comfortable in to find stillness.
Beautiful.
Theo, have you tried Hero's Pose like Rose is doing? Is that okay? Yeah, and yeah, like Angela's doing. Because. Allowing the body to be comfortable in the seat is a portal into meditation. There you go, yep. And the knees can be apart and then support your sits bones with the block, yeah. And then if you're able to come up the right knee, no.
Yeah.
You want to use the chair?
No, just
okay. Maybe try bringing your feet.
Or is, are the knees okay?
Okay, yeah.
Where you're standing there.
Oh, beautiful. That's for you.
So allowing the eyes to soften. Just a few words to share before moving into meditation today. Meditation provides us with the freedom, with that freedom, or with a free, sorry, with a freedom by connecting us to the eternal, unchanging reality within us. Don't expect to empty your mind of thoughts completely, because it's within our nature to think. The goal is not to blank your mind. The goal is to be able to let go of the mind's thoughts, to not be pulled into every thought that arises. Meditation develops the virtue of sama, which means to calm. And therefore, to be able to control the thoughts, the citta, which are the whirlings of the mind. Sama enables us to be quiet, calm, and tranquil in the midst of the whirlings. By means of the steadiness of sama, when your mind gets distracted, you can bring it back to a place of equanimity. You can't make yourself meditate. It will arise on its own organically. But for that to happen, we do have to apply some effort to develop our ability to focus. So to focus our mind today, we're going to use that mantra, let go. So begin just silently repeating it to yourself on your inhale, let. And on your exhale, go. Inhale, let. Exhale, go. By focusing on repeating that mantra over and over, physical thoughts start to subside. Maybe there's an itch that you feel you need to scratch, but by just focusing on repeating the mantra, you might find that the urge subsides. Or maybe a pain in your low back starts to ache. bring your awareness immediately back to let go. Feeling the force of gravity drawing your seat downward. And as you surrender to this downward force, you may feel an uplifting force moving through your spine and torso. The force of levitation operating within you. When you find that your mind is becoming disturbed, losing its calmness, come back to the mantra, let go. Noticing its calming effect. slowly start to move the fingers a little bit, opening and closing. Take a deeper inhale, sigh it out through the mouth. Maybe bring the hands together, interlace the fingers, and just make some figure eights with the wrists. Let's inhale, circling the arms overhead. Drawing the hands down to heart center, two more times. Inhale, the arms circling them overhead. Drawing down to heart center, last time. Inhale, circle overhead. Just bringing them to heart center, soft bow of the head toward your heart. Thank yourself for being here. For inviting meditation to be part of your life. Just recalling your intention, just recall any moments of calmness today that you're able to maybe take with you. You can practice this mantra, let go, off the mat throughout your day. Anytime that you might feel stress or anxiety rising in you or agitation, just take 3 inhales and exhales, silently repeating, let go. That's practicing meditation throughout your day. Let's close with the sound of Om. Take a full inhale, sigh it out. Thank you, friends.